new case again. We are here with the case of Bayes' theorem or Bayes' law of inverse probability, or say prior probability, conditional probability, joint probability, marginal probability, and posterior or revised or inverse probability of the causality. The case is, if the probabilities of X, Y, and Z becoming C, E, O, R, 4 by 9, 2 by 9, and 1 by 3. 1 by 3 can be taken as 3 by 9. The probability is that the bonus scheme will be introduced if X, Y, and Z becomes C, E, O, R, 1 by 10, 1 by 2, 4 by 5 respectively. That means, if X becomes, introduction of bonus scheme, if X becomes CEO, 1 by 10, if Y becomes CEO, 1 by 2, if Z becomes CEO, it is 1 by 5. So these are conditional probabilities of introducing a bonus scheme if so and so becomes CEO. If the bonus scheme has been introduced, that means if we come to know that bonus scheme has been introduced in the organization, what are the probabilities, that means what are the posterior or revised or inverse probabilities that the CEO appointed was A, X, or Y, or Z. So there are three cause events, the candidates X, Y, Z, their prior probabilities are already available, 4 by 9, 2 by 9, and 3 by 9. Conditional probability of introducing bonus schemes if X or Y or Z becoming CEO are also available. If we multiply these two, then we can have the joint probability of appointment of particular candidate and introducing bonus scheme, and on the basis of this we can have the marginal probability of introducing a bonus scheme irrespective of any candidate becoming CEO, and ultimately we can calculate the posterior or revised or inverse probability of particular candidate becoming CEO on the basis of the knowledge about the event that bonus scheme has been introduced. So the first candidate X, let us use sign A1 for X. Probability of A1 is 4 by 9. Conditional probability of introducing bonus scheme if X becomes CEO, that is B given A1, is given to be 1 by 10. If we multiply these two, we can have P of A1 intersection B. That means X is selected and a bonus scheme is introduced. 4 by 9 into 1 by 10, that is 4 by 90. Now, another is, candidate is Y. Use sign A2 for him, P of A2, selection of Y, 2 by 9. P of B given A2, that is probability, conditional probability of introducing a bonus scheme if Y is selected or appointed as CEO, that is given to be 1 by 2, that is 5 by 10. I would prefer to make the denominator same. That will make the calculation of marginal probability and posterior probability somewhat easier. If we multiply these two, that will be P of A2 intersection B. That is, Y becomes CEO and bonus scheme is introduced. 2 by 9 into 5 by 10. That will be 10 by 90. And third is Z. Use sign A3 for him or her. P of A3, probability of Z becoming CEO is 1 by 3, that is 3 by 9. Again, maintaining the same denominator. P of B given A3, that is probability of introducing a bonus scheme if Z becomes CEO, is given to be 4 by 5, that is 8 by 10. Summation of these three or these conditional probability can never be expected as 1. It can be less than 1, it can be exactly 1, it can be greater than 1. The summation of these conditional probabilities. Yes, P of A3 intersection B, that is Z is selected as CEO and bonus scheme is introduced. Multiplication of these two, 3 into 3 by 9 into 8 by 10, 24 by 90. If we add these three, the result will be P of B, that is probability of introducing a bonus scheme irrespective of the candidate. That is 38 by 90. I am not going to simplify this. This is marginal probability of introducing bonus scheme. P of B. Whoever becomes CEO, but probability of introducing a bonus scheme in the organization comes to 38 by 90. Yes, now we can calculate the posterior probabilities of X, Y and Z becoming CEO if we have the knowledge about the fact that bonus scheme has been introduced. That will be P of A1 given B. Probability of X becoming CEO if bonus scheme has been introduced. It will be P of A1 intersection B, that is 4 by 90 divided by P of B, 38 by 90. That will be 4 by 90 into 90 by 38. So it comes to 4 by 38. Similarly, P of A2 given B, that is probability of Z appointed as CEO if bonus scheme has been introduced. That will be P of A2 intersection B, A2 intersection B, 10 by 90, divided by P of B, 38 by 90. That is equivalent to 10 by 90 multiplied by 90 by 38. So it will be 10 by 38. We can simplify it, but to verify the total of 1, I am maintaining the total 38 as it is. The third possibility or third probability rather, P of A3 given B, that is Z becomes CEO and, sorry, if bonus scheme has been introduced, that is P of A3 intersection B, 24 by 90 divided by P of B, 38 by 90, that is equivalent to 24 by 90 into 90 by 38. So it comes to 24 by 38. These three are posterior probabilities. If we verify the summation of three posterior probabilities and three prior probabilities and three posterior probabilities must be 1, and in this case they are. So there is no mistake in the calculation. So, we use the tabular approach to find the posterior or revised or inverse probability of the cause events. That's it. Thank you very much.